Welcome to corrective exercise number 15. I'm Anthony Carey with Function First in San Diego. And again, I have with me my friend Jeff Groh from Authentic Motion, authenticmotion.com. And today we're going to go through one of the exercises in the pain-free program. Corrective exercise number 15 is going to be the sitting thoracic and cervical extension. Love this exercise. It's one of those very posturally related exercises. There's not a lot of movement involved, but what it does is it really helps the client become proprioceptively aware of some of what their thoracic spine has to do in the position of the scapula, and as well as positioning some segmental changes through the thoracic, upper thoracic, and into the cervical spine. And this is a great exercise for, you know, all the desk jockeys that we have out there. Everybody's got their head down and they're rounding through the thoracic spine. So, you know, question often comes up, is this a stretching or is this a strengthening exercise? And the answer is yes. You know, so often we have clients go through a stretching movement or an overhead extension, or they do it on their own intuitively, but they'll hold it for 5 or 10 seconds. When we get somebody to hold one of these positions in these static postures, we're actually going to get a lot of facilitation through all the motor units that innervate these muscles, where you get an increase in circulation. With the increase in the motor units, there's an increase in proprioceptive awareness, and we'll literally get some minor segmental changes. And so the client and even yourself will notice a distinct difference if you stand up after doing this exercise for 5 or 10 seconds versus if you actually hold it for 30 to 45 seconds. So we're not going to torture Jeff too much. We're only going to have him hold it for about 30 seconds. But positionally, he's going to be sitting on the floor with the knees bent, the feet are on the floor. And we do this a little bit because we want the lumbar spine to actually stay a little bit flexed, or at least minimize its contribution to this exercise. If the legs are out straight, sometimes what will happen is the fulcrum of the ischial tuberosity changes, and the person can actually contribute to some of their thoracic extension with a little help from the lumbar spine. So that's why we're going to keep the feet bent. And we're also going to allow the client to be able to get a little bit of ground reaction force, a little bit of traction with the feet there. So Jeff's going to put his hands behind his back. Now what's really important about this part is that he's got all 10 fingers pointing away from him, which is basically he's supinating, and then therefore he's externally rotating at the glenohumeral joint. By doing that, staying extended at the elbow, the scapula has no choice but to accommodate that position and start to adduct and actually rotate a little bit for us. And then what we're going to cue Jeff to do now is really push through his mid-thoracic back into some extension. Again, that helps positionally, we minimize the lumbar contribution. He feels the expansion here. Again, now we've actually got relative motion of the humerus on the scapula. It's the scapula is moving, not the humeral head. Now we're going to get a little bit of depression with that too. So now we've got thoracic extension going on all the way up into the upper segments. Now, as long as your client or your athlete's cervical spine allows it, we're going to have Jeff drop his head back gently and slowly, because what we want to see happen here is that the extension occurs all the way up through the upper thoracic, lower cervical, and then all the way to the upper cervical segments. Once he's in this position, he's doing a lot of work through his mid-back here. His cervical flexors are getting lengthened through here. He's opening up through his chest, obviously, and again, he's going to hold it. There's some effort here. We're not just going to get into the position and then come out of it. What we see often as a mistake in folks is that the scaps will actually ride up because they can't facilitate the right spot in their mid-thoracic spine. That will actually change the way that the upper thoracic, lower cervical respond, and will actually be in a little bit of flexion up there. So we're going to have Jeff come out of this now, and then we're going to give you another view where he's going to turn with his back to the camera so that you can see what's going on here. Now, modification of this simply is, let's not have them bring their cervical spine into full extension. What can your client tolerate? This is an unfamiliar position, and therefore, because it's the neck, sometimes clients will get a little bit apprehensive about the motion, and then they'll start to tighten up and they won't relax into it. But if you can get them to comfortably move into the position, and then once Jeff gets his head all the way back as he pushes again through the thoracic spine, once he gets his head all the way back, at this point, he should just be completely relaxed. Gravity's acting on his head. He's not engaging his cervical flexors here. Anything in the anterior portion of his neck to hold himself up, it should be completely passive at this point as we open up through here. So much of what we do all day, especially in the mid to lower cervical segments or in flexion as we're looking down at computers, at our food, and everything else that we're doing. And again, secondary to this is he's actually, for a lot of people, they're going to get some lengthening through the forearm flexors and even the pronators because, again, he's supinated and he's in elbow extension here. So we're getting some benefit up through the upper extremity as well. And, of course, lots of opening going on through here. Great job, sir. We welcome your feedback and your comments, and hope you can help implement this with your clients.